Bible and them. It's only God has kept us till now. It's not because we are better than those who have gone. It's only that He has just shown us mercy. May His mercies continue over our lives forever in Jesus' name. Today we'll be looking at something from the scriptures, Luke chapter 2. Luke chapter 2. We'll read from verse 40 to verse 44. There's a question that I believe the Holy Spirit will want us to consider this morning. Luke 2 from verse 40. I read. And the child grieved. Are you there? Are you there? And the child grieved and became strong, filled with the wisdom and the favor of God was upon him. Verse 41. Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, he went up according to the custom. And when the feast was ended, as they were returning, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. His parents did not know it, but supposing him to be in the group, they went a day's journey. But then they began to search for him among their relatives and acquaintances. Let's go there. We're discussing today this question, where is the boy? Where is the boy? This is a story we know very well. Let's just run through it. Before this time, Herod has sought to kill the boy, and you know the story. An angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and told him, take this boy and the mother, run away to Egypt. I'm going to give you information what next to do. And after Herod had died, Jesus was brought back to Nazareth. And here we were told he was 12 years. And normally, his parents would go to Jerusalem for the feast of the Passover every year. At this particular point in time, they went with who? Jesus Christ. Mary and Joseph going with their child, Jesus. Just like when we go for the convention. So when they got there, I wouldn't know how long it took them, but we were told after the feast, they were returned back home. How many of them came from that family? Mary, Joseph, and Jesus. Three. But when they finished, Joseph and Mary were gone. And the boy was missing. Only three of them. Okay. But two were returning. And the list that they were supposed to be giving zero, 100% attention was left there. Out of 12 years. Probably, if it were to be today, that boy would be in the probably GST. GST. 12 years. And they continued that journey one whole day. They did not know that Jesus was not with them. All of a sudden, after one whole day, probably people started to branch off. They were going into their own houses and said, where is Jesus Christ? And they said to themselves, we assumed, we thought he was with some colleagues, some friends, some neighbors. Excuse me, did they go with some neighbors? Did they hand him over to some neighbors while they were going? And the question is, where is the boy? Before we begin to look at how this applies to us, let's just look at it. Who was missing? Who was missing? Jesus. Now, who was Jesus at that point in time?
The boy.
Huh?
The boy.
Eh?
The boy.
Let's just take it one by one. Jesus, as he was at that point, was God. A man, right? He came to save that which was lost. I mean, seek and save that which was lost. So, the father and the mother went for a feast in Jerusalem, the feast of Passover, which was started in Egypt when God delivered the people. And that was a pointer. Pointer to one thing, that a time is coming when God will come down and deliver you from destruction. He's going to shed his blood for you to escape eternal destruction. That was the essence of Passover. And in accomplishing that, he sent Jesus, who came and came through that family of Mary and Joseph. All of a sudden, this person who was supposed to be the one who will deliver the whole world talked to me. Who was Jesus? His name is Emmanuel, that is God with us. God with Mary and Joseph got missing. So if God with us was supposed to be with them, he was missing. So who was with them? Nothing. The deliverer, Jesus, was with them, but they were careless, he got missing. The light of the world was with them, but they allowed him to go missing. So where were they? In darkness. The glory of the world was with them, but it got missing. So what did they have? Shame. And they traveled like that for one whole day from Jerusalem to Nazareth without the glory of God, without Emmanuel, without the deliverer, without the ancient of days, without the light. They went one whole day based on assumption. They assumed that they had gone with somebody. And when they realized they traveled again and not, they had one day making two. And on the third day, they found him in the temple. 12-year-old, no food, no water, probably in the temple. What was he doing? Discussing with the people. We will try our best with them, but I know our best will not be. God will help us. Are you there? Then God will help us.
Amen.
Several things to pick out of it. Excuse me. By the time you get to verse 45, when that boy was eventually found, it was the mother that spoke, not the father. Mary looked at the boy and said, "Boy, oh son, why did you do us like this? Myself and your father have been so worried." The father never said anything. And eventually the boy said, "Well, don't you know I have to be about the business of my father, blah, 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 blah. Let's be tied up together then. I think we can pray." I started to think about it. But why? An angel came to you to say to you that you will have a baby and this and this and that. And now you have the baby. And you are careless about the baby. Many times you have received precious promises from God. Probably in church services like this. Probably at personal retreats. God has given you promises. You had it clearly. You were so convinced of it. But you were careless with it. And it slipped off. Just like Jesus was taken to Jerusalem. And people were careless. I mean, the parents were careless. He stayed back. And for the period of time they did not see him, they were in serious trouble. Probably you have lost precious promises because of your assuming nature. You assume someone is going to do it, someone is going to help you out, someone will help you out doing it, and nobody did. And you went back to square one. It's possible your marriage is what it is now based on that stupid assumption. Someone, how dare you commit God's promise into neighbor's hand? And you were not even sure. It wasn't that you handed it to him, said, "Please help us take this child. We will soon meet you on the way." What load were they carrying? What was it that became so much of them that they did not have attention? They could not give attention to that thing that God specifically sent an angel to come and help them. Probably the trouble you are going through today, based on this glory thing we are shouting about, is because at one point in time or the other, you committed that glorious thing God handed over to you to someone else carelessly, or you did not even bother about it at all. You just assumed. Just assumed. And you left it like that. Look at the parents. It's so pathetic that a parent will be able to do like that. And I really don't blame Joseph. Because some of us behave like that. In the real sense of it, was Joseph the father of Jesus? Huh?
If you have experiences with those who probably have stepsisters and stepdaughters, stepsons and things like that, you know what I'm talking about. It's possible Joseph just looked at it and said, I really wanted to divorce this woman, if not for the angel that came to me. Is it not true? I wouldn't know. She told me it was a name, it was the Holy Spirit. How do I prove it's the Holy Spirit? How do I take care of the boy? I don't know the father. You can die, let him die. How do we explain it? Now you saw the boy, you should have taken him and spanked him. So what went wrong with you? Why would you do it? And talk. If it were to be Joseph's son, wouldn't he put yourself in his shoes? You have come to convention for convention. It's a redeemed convention. In the midst of the multitude. Then you left and you didn't see the ball. Eventually, if you see that ball, if you look at your shoes will have turned brown. If you see it, if you tap that ball, you will kick, you will move everything. Probably he just smiled, or he didn't even go that. What is my hope? You came to me to tell me an angel. How do I know it's an angel? How do I know it's a spirit? You want me to take care of the person I don't know the father? I don't know how he came about. He doesn't even resemble me. But see, he didn't know that he was so privileged. Because in tomorrow, we still say Jesus, the son of Joseph. Was he the father? No. Many of us have landed ourselves in the trouble. Let's just take it literally like that. Probably for one thing or the other, your wife had a child while out of wedlock or something. Or your husband out of wedlock. And now you are married. And he's trying to do everything to please you, but you are looking at that boy as a useless boy, and then you treat him just like not even like a slave. If I'd be like a slave, it would have been better. Because as if he should just die. I want to say to you, you have to rethink. You may be handling the glory of your life in a messy way. If somebody had told Mrs. Potiphar that Joseph was going to become the prime minister, she would not have attempted what she did. Because you know what it means for you now to come with your hands behind you, and you come before the person you sent to jail for what he did not do. And say, sir, you can't call me by name anymore. You say, sir, please, you need food. Take care. No food for you yet. You know, you don't stand before him and look at him in the face anymore. If she had known, assuming she treated him the way she's supposed to treat him, what do you think would have happened? She would not leave her house and she would send to Joseph and say, please take care of madam. She would even refer to her as madam. Only if God can open our eyes to see our future. And then we will change our behavior. We will change our attitudes. We will change our thinking. Several things. You have a child in the house because that's one you don't know where he came from, or you were not in agreement, and he's going to be the one to do everything. He's going to wash the plate, he's going to wash the car, he's going to wash the clothes, he's going to do everything, You think you're polishing that child? No. And people say, Adam, you don't have a bad habit of money. And I bet you, look through the scriptures. Only pray that it won't be that the light of your family is what you are treating like that. Because if it goes away, then there will be darkness. May you not experience darkness. Amen. So may you not experience darkness.
Amen.
If Joseph had known that God was working out something for him, probably would have paid more attention, better attention. Would have paid better attention. And you know what? Psalm 127:3. 127 verse 3 says it, children are the heritage of the Lord. So that child that God gave to Joseph and Mary did not belong to them. God just tell them the gift. He said, get me off as you belong and labara. Bene a woman. Only ibuku ni fun okurina. Blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. Put it the other way. The man who doesn't have his quiver full of them is. Let me call it for some.
So if God committed something into their head, they were supposed to take care of it, and they were careless with it. They left.